Now let's look at question number 4 on gears. After this we'll move on to the next topic in this particular chapter, that is gear trains. Okay, so the question says we have two 3 millimeter module, 20 degree pressure angle in volutes per gears which mesh externally to give a velocity ratio of 4. The addendum is 1.2 times the module. The pinion rotates at 150 rpm. Determine the minimum number of teeth on each gear to avoid interference and the contact ratio. Let's quickly write down the data given to you. So module is 3 mm, M is 3 mm. It is given that addendum is 1.2 times module. So this becomes 3.6 millimeter, isn't it? Because M is 3. The alpha is 20 degrees, the N1 is 150 rpm, okay, and the velocity ratio is 4. Now if I find out the minimum number of teeth on, let us say, gear first of all, so it will be Z2, which is 2 times AG upon under root 1 plus 1 by I square sine square alpha plus 2 by I sine square alpha minus 1. So let's put in the values. So 2 into 1.2 upon 1 plus 1 by 16 sin square 20 degrees plus 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 again this minus 1. So this equation would give you a value which is approximately 76. So Z2 is 76. With Z2 76, the value of Z1 would be 76 by 4. That's the velocity ratio. And this will be 19. So your pinion has 19 teeth on the minimum side and your gear has a minimum of 76 teeth to avoid interference. Okay, so this takes care of the first part of the question. Now let's come to the second part and talk about the contact ratio. So let's start with the contact ratio. So we need to find out the value for the addendum radius for pinion and for gear, and also we need to find out the pitch circle radius. So the pitch circle radius for pinion is R1, which would be module into Z1 by 2. So this becomes 3 into 19 by 2, which becomes 28.5 millimeters. You multiply that by 4, you get R2. Which is M into Z2 by 2. So 28.5 into 4 would give you approximately 114 millimeters. So you get R1 and you get R2. You already have the addendum over here. So I can find out RA1 and RA2. Okay. So RA1 is 28.5 plus 3.6. That's 32.1. Okay, and RA2 would be 114 plus 3.6, that's 117.6. Okay, so this is RA2. We also need R1 cos alpha and R2 cos alpha. So R1 cos alpha is 28.5 cos 20 degrees. Okay, this would be 26.78 millimeters, and your R2 cos alpha would be 114 cos 20. This will be 107.12 millimeters. Okay, so this is the values which we'll use to calculate LP. So LP is under root आर ए वन स्क्वायर माइनस आर वन स्क्वायर इंटू कॉस स्क्वायर अल्फा प्लस अंडर रूट आर ए टू स्क्वायर माइनस आर टू स्क्वायर कॉस स्क्वायर अल्फा ओके माइनस आर वन प्लस आर टू इंटू साइन अल्फा. यू प्लग इन ऑल द वैल्यूज विच आर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टेबल एंड दिस विल गिव यू एन एल पी ऑफ अराउंड 17.5 मिलीमीटर्स. सो दैट इज योर एल पी. सो योर कॉन्टैक्ट रेशियो इज एल पी अपॉन बैक पिच. सो इट इज 17.49. बैक पिच इज पी कॉस अल्फा. नाउ व्हाट इज पिच? पाई इंटू मॉड्यूल. यू गेट 17.49 अपॉन पाई इंटू मॉड्यूल विच इज 3 इंटू कॉस 20. सो दिस विल रिजल्ट इन अ वैल्यू विच इज 1.975 which is almost equal to 2. So we have two gears in contact at any given point of time. So again, a very, very simple question which makes use of the formulas for the minimum number of teeth on gear and pinion. Alright, so I hope you got this. Now after gears, we'll move on to the next topic in this chapter and start talking about the gear trains.